Sometimes you're going to come across circuits where it's not possible to reduce the circuit using just series and parallel combinations. Let's see if we can reduce this circuit by combining resistors. If we look at this node and walk down the conductor, we see that it splits the current here. And if we go this way, it's the same thing and we can't do anything because of this resistor in the middle. In other words, there aren't any resistors in series or parallel. So how can we simplify this circuit? To do this, we need to use something called a Y to delta or delta to Y transformation. Let's focus on this part of the circuit. So what we want to do is convert this into this. The reason this is called the delta is because the Greek letter delta looks like this. This is called the Y because it sort of looks like a Y shape. Anyways, let's label these points A, B, C, so then the corresponding points on the Y can be labeled A, B, C. On the Y, we will label the resistors based on the node letter it's connected to. So we have RA, RB, and RC. I will show the equations representing these resistors, and then we can go through them. You don't need to memorize this because you can just see the pattern on how this works. So if we look at the first equation, it tells us the value of RA. Looking at point A on the delta, we can see that it's connected to R1 and R2. So those are going to be multiplied by each other on the top of our fraction. The bottom is just the addition of all the resistors. Let's look at the value for RB. We look to see the two resistors connected to point B. We see that it's resistor 2 and 3. So that's going to be up top. The bottom is the same, just the addition of all the resistors. You probably already see that RC would be R1 and R3 multiplied and then divided by the addition of all the resistors. So the top is always the two resistors that's connected to the point, while the bottom is the sum of all the resistors. Sometimes these deltas and y's aren't always oriented like shown here. But what's important to remember is that your y should correspond to the labeling you used. So notice A to A, B to B, and C to C. Also, some books will use RAC, RAB, and RBC instead of numbers. So use whichever method you like better. Anyways, once we get the RA, RB, and RC values, we can replace the delta on our circuit with the Y. Now it's much easier to combine resistors since these two are in series. This can be done in the opposite direction too, so we can go from a Y to a delta. So let's look at those equations. Don't be alarmed, these are just as easy to figure out as the other ones. Notice that on top, it's the same for all three resistors. The top is just the sum of each resistor multiplied by each other. So these two multiplied together, then these two, and lastly these two. The bottom is always the opposite resistor value. So notice how opposite to R1 is point B. That means the bottom is going to be RB. Let's look at R2. Opposite to it is point C, so the bottom will be RC. Lastly, opposite to R3 is A, so bottom will be RA. If by some chance you get resistors in a delta or a Y with the exact same resistor values, then you don't need to do much. The value of each resistor in the Y would be 1/3 the resistor value. The value of the delta would be 3 times the value of each resistor. That's all there is to it, so let's do a few examples to see how this works with numerical values. Let's take a look at this question where we need to find I0. Now if we look, we see that there are no ways we can combine resistors through series or parallel means. So we need to look for a Y or a delta. Here we can see that these three resistors are connected in a delta pattern. If it's hard to see, try to bend these connectors in your mind so you can visualize it easier. These three are also in a delta, but we will work on the top resistors since the math will be easier. They're all 12 ohm resistors. So let's label our points. We can also draw out the Y so that we can visualize it better. Now we can figure out each of the resistor values on our Y. In fact, All of these will equal 4 ohms because our resistors share the same value, which means it'll be 1/3 the value of each resistor. Now we can replace our delta with the Y. Looking at our new circuit, we see that these resistors are in series, and so are these ones. So let's combine them. Now we see that these two resistors are in parallel. So let's combine those. Lastly, we see that these two resistors are now in series. So let's add them. The current will flow like this, so our positives and negatives on the resistor will be here. Now we can figure out the current in the circuit using Ohm's law. This current we found is the same for both of these resistors since we added them in series. So using that, we can figure out the voltage in this resistor. Now the voltage we found is the same for both of these resistors since we added these two in parallel to get this resistor. The last step is to figure out the current flowing through this resistor. This current value we found is the same current flowing through these resistors, which is also I0. So that's our answer. Let's take a look at this question where we need to figure out I0. Looking at the circuit, we can straight away see that these three resistors are in series. So let's combine them. Now, we see that these two resistors are parallel to each other, so we can combine them too. So now we have this weird looking circuit and really no other ways to combine the rest of the resistors. But there is a Y formation in this circuit between these resistors. Now it might be hard for some to see, but that's okay. Let's redraw this circuit in a way that makes it easier for us to see. To redraw a circuit, we first need to label our points. Next, we look for a place we can start at. Here, the power source is a good foundation spot, so let's draw the power source between points A and D. Next, we're going to extend these wires a bit so we have more space to see what's going on. Now, between points A and B, we have this 2 ohm resistor, so let's draw it as is. Now, let's focus on point C. Notice how it has 3 branches attached to it. We have CA, CB, and CD. So I'm going to label a point in the middle as point C on our new circuit. From A to C, we have a 9 ohm resistor, so let's draw it. Then we have a 6 ohm resistor from points B to C, let's draw that. Next, we have an 18 ohm resistor between points D and C. Now we can draw it like this, but that doesn't really look nice, so I'm going to draw it straight down while extending the wires towards the center. The last wire we need to account for is the connection between D and B. There is a 12 ohm resistor on that conductor, so let's draw it. And that's our circuit redrawn. One thing you should do is go back and do a quick check to make sure these circuits are equivalent. So let's take a look. Looking at point A, it's connected to B, C, and D, so that's true on our new circuit. Between A and B, we have a 2 ohm resistor. Between A and C, we have a 9 ohm resistor. Between A and D, we have the voltage source. The rest you can check just like I did to make sure these are the same circuits. Now we can easily see that there is a Y between these resistors. So we can convert it to a delta. Let's label our points and draw a delta on the side. Now we can solve for each resistor. The next step is to replace the Y with the delta. Instead of keeping these wires bent, we can straighten them out. Now we see that these two resistors are parallel to each other, so let's combine them. Again, looking at the circuit, we can see that these two resistors are now parallel, so let's add those together. Next, we can see that these two resistors are in series, so let's add those. Now we have a parallel circuit with a single voltage source, so that means both of these resistors have a voltage of 36 volts. Remember, in a parallel circuit, the voltage is the same for all elements. Knowing this, we can calculate the current in each conductor. Current will flow this way, so our positives and negatives will look like this. Let's use Ohm's law to figure out the currents. Since we combine two resistors in series to get this parallel resistor, the current will be the same for both. That means we can figure out the voltage in this resistor. We get 6 volts. Now remember, we combined these two resistors in parallel to get this resistor, so that means the voltage is the same for both. We can now solve for I0 using Ohm's law. We get 3 amps, and that's our answer. Let's take a look at this question, where we need to figure out the value of V0. Looking at the circuit, we can see that these resistors are in a delta formation. If it's hard to see, let's move these conductors like this, and that should make it easier. So let's label our points. On the side, we will draw the Y and label its points. Next, it's just a matter of using the equations to get the values of our resistors. Now that we have the new values, we can replace our delta with the Y. Looking at our new circuit, these two are in series, and so are these two. So let's add them together. Next, we see that these two resistors are parallel to each other, so let's combine those. Lastly, these two resistors are in series, so we can add those together. Current will flow this way, so that means the positives and negatives for our resistor will be like this. Now we can use Ohm's law to figure out the current in the circuit. Since we added two resistors in series to get this resistor, we know the current will be the same for both of them. Remember, in a series circuit, the current is the same. Now we can solve for the voltage in the 4K ohm resistor. Now this voltage we found is the same for both of these resistors, since they were combined in parallel. That means we can figure out the current flowing through this resistor. We're just working backwards until we get to the 6K ohm resistor to get the voltage, since that's what the question is asking for. The last step is to use the current we just found to figure out the voltage in the 6K ohm resistor. And that's our answer. That should cover the types of problems you will face when it comes to Y to delta and delta to Y transformations. Thanks for watching, and best of luck with your studies.